What up, beautiful people? It is your homegirl, Shameless, all up in your building. We is back for a Techie Tuesday, where I break it down for all you technological geeks or wannabe geeks. This is for beginners, so if you're not a beginner, you don't need to watch this, but feel free if you'd like to be entertained by a shamelessness. But okay, so I did a poll on my Facebook page asking you guys what did they want to see this Tuesday for techie stuff, and there was a lot of feedback, but the most popular one was the voiceovers. I briefly touched on this on one of my techie videos that I'll put like here or something, but I do have a playlist on all my techie photo video videos, so just click on that, which is in the description box. Make sure you guys watch those videos. They're like 5 minutes a video, so watch that if you have any questions. Okay, so the first thing you need to know about audio is the sound quality. Now, one way to manipulate that is your environment and where you're recording. So I am in my living room, and I do live in New York City, so it is at times hard for me to control the sound. I try to record at night when it is kind of quieter, not really. In the daytime, I have all the trucks. There's still some trucks out there. At night, I got all the guys on the block that are really loud outside, but you do what you can with what you got. So you just want to make sure you're in an environment where it's quiet for the most part. If you are doing a voiceover, which is recording the audio without the visuals, the video, you can find yourself a quiet space. I sometimes use my closet. So I'll just go in here. That's the sound from the sounds of New York. And then I use these as like sound absorbers. So I'll just talk in here like so.
Why, hello there. What's your name?
You guys always comment about my like seductive voice or whatever. I think that's coming because I don't want to pop my peas. Papa. So you just gotta, I have to make sure that I don't like, blah, I'm loud, so I gotta keep it low. Low and sexy, bobo. Low and sexy, boo. I'm super, super thrifty, frugal, ghetto. Sometimes I use my blanket. I'll just sit on my bed and throw a blanket over me. Par example of this. So I'll just,
does it sound better? You tell me.
So what's your name? Do you wanna make out?
Okay, so that's one way you can manipulate the sound. The other way is, where are you pulling your audio from? Are you going to be pulling it from the video, or are you going to be pulling it from an external microphone, such as this H4N Zoom mic? This one you can buy from any techie store. I do have an Amazon store online if you would like to buy this. This is on the pricier end of things, but it's an investment. If you don't have the budget for this, just use the audio that is built into your camera. It might not be the greatest quality, but again, you can manipulate things with, you know, with towels or closets or whatever the case is. What else? Oh, I have an iPhone. I'm an iPhone user. The audio on this is superb. I'm going to be recording my voice through the voice memo, and I have an iPhone 5S, and I use this usually when I forget this. I'm like, crap, I forgot my H4N Zoom mic. So I use this. Now there's also a microphone that you can buy, an external microphone that you can hook up into your camera. Now the most popular one out there is called the Rode mic. They do range in price. So what that microphone does is it sits on the top of your camera. If you have a hot shoe on the top of your camera, as my camera does, you just sit it on top and then you plug the sucker into the side and the audio is recorded into the camera. Once you have all your audio recorded, you're gonna import that footage and audio file into Final Cut. I don't use any other editing software, so for you guys, if you're asking me about, you know, PC users, Sony, Vegas, all these things, I have no idea. I don't work on anything but what I have. So now you're going to join me in the editing room as we edit this sucker. Yes, we are in my computer. I love the Cosbys. And now we're in the Matrix. This is Final Cut Pro 10, guys. Get with it. Now, to import your audio files, you're gonna hit File, Import Media. Shortcut is Command-I. So I'm gonna import this audio file right here. Enter, enter. Yes. Now, why isn't it coming up? Well, F you too. For whatever reason, this is being super glitchy. But anyways, the point is, that's how you import a file. Okay, so the audio you just heard. That? Nonsense, DJ Scratch. That is the built-in audio from the video. And this is the external audio. Now to sync them up, Final Cut has made it super simple. You select the audio file, then you hit Command, and you select the video file. You go to Clip, Synchronize, and it will create a new file over here. And that is going to be the new clip that has two audio files, the built-in and the external audio. So once that says 100%, means the computer is done working its magic, and you can drag this onto the timeline, okay? This is where we edit. Whoa. Okay, get used to those sounds. Now you're gonna hit right-click and expand audio components. You will have your video file here, your built-in audio file here, and your external audio file here. And you will see that Final Cut has synced them up. Now, in this case, my external audio, the volume is low. So I'm going to raise that up a bit. Now, if I hit the letter Z and zoom in, these little red areas mean that the volume has peaked. It's really loud. So that's just something to be aware of. I'm going to be talking about a lot of shortcuts because it's all about shortcuts with Macs. Now, if you hit the letter V, that will disable the volume on whatever track you're on. It'll even disable the video. So now the two audio files are disabled. Now, so you can hear the difference between the built-in and the external audio, I will disable the external, and this is the built-in audio.
There we go. What a beautiful people. It is your homegirl.
That built-in audio was very echoey. So I'm going to hit the V, which disabled that, and I'm going to hit this, select the external audio, and hit V again so you can hear it. And you'll hear the difference.
But it is your homegirl, Shameless, all up in your building.
Okay, now you can adjust and manipulate the volume by raising this bar here. So 12 is the highest, minus 100, and so on and so forth. Maybe I'll bring it to 7. Now, for areas like this, where this is if you want to get really technical, let me just raise it all the way to 12, okay? And I will look for areas that the volume peaks, like over here. So if you zoom in, where'd you go? Okay, here. I am going to hit the letter P. And if you hit Option and click, hold Option again and click, you have these two little dots. Can you guys see that? Let me zoom in. So you have this one dot here and this one dot here. So you're gonna put four dots down. So one dot here, whoops. Option click, Option click. Okay, so now if you just select the volume here and lower it, down to 5, the volume doesn't peak as much. Now this is helpful if there's like a loud sound, or in this case it's just my voice. I get more excited in some places and not so much in others. But since this is a video on sound, I thought I should share that with you. So here, again, hit the letter P, Option click, Option click, Option click, Option click. Four little dots, okay? And just bring this sucker down. Now we're gonna zoom out, and to zoom in and out, all you do is hit the letter Z, Option, hold it down, and you'll see that the zoom goes minus. If you don't hold Option and you just click it, that's to zoom in. There's a lot of info, guys. There's a lot. Now, once you are done working on the audio file, all you gotta do is right-click and hit Collapse Audio Component. Now see, it's all one strip of file. And that is how you manipulate your voiceover. This is how you synchronize the two tracks. Comprende? And say you had music. You could just go in here. I'll just type in J. Elliott. Let's see, Retro Boogie. What you all know about Retro Boogie, okay? This is a track that we haven't released yet, okay? The music, and let me put the volume up.
a beautiful people.
Now that's too loud, so I'm going to bring the volume on this overall down.
Shamelessness. But, okay, so I did a poll on my Facebook page.
See that? We learned about the option click to create those little dots. There's another one. Now I only have two in this case. Now I can bring this down, you see? So it'll start loud and then gradually fade out. And I can bring this further out, I can drag it, and I can lower it. So you'll see how it works. And I hit the space bar to press play.
There we go. What a beautiful people. It is your homegirl Shameless, all up in your building. We are back for a Techie Tuesday where I break it down for all you technological geeks or wannabe geeks. This is for beginners. So if you're not a beginner, you don't need to.
Voila! That's it. If you guys have any questions regarding, photo video stuff, maybe some suggestions on videos you want to see, make sure you watch the playlist in the description box below. Because there's a wealth of information in those videos that I took the time to film and edit for you guys. So check it out. Tune in every Tuesday for Techie Tuesday. I have an Amazon link in the description box on where you can buy my microphone, all that fun stuff. I have some random things on my Amazon store. And P.S. you guys, this is just stuff on Amazon. Like, I just created a store. I don't ship anything out. I just pulled products and put it into one place for you guys so it's easier when you're searching. An audio question. You know what? I would love to know what song you guys are jamming to at the moment. Comment below. Oh, I should probably do a video on music. Would you guys want to see a video on music? All that jazzy stuff, licensing, and gives me a headache. But anyways, if you would, comment below. Also, let me know your song of the moment or your all-time favorite song. Remember, guys, to do you, be you, and stay true. Be shameless. Be a geek. Stay in school. Watch videos after.
Peace.